Okay, so we've got some big, big pigs. They eat a lot. So how are we gonna deal with that? That's coming up next. Hello everyone, this is Dwayne with Edge of Nowhere Farm, and I'm here in our pig pen. So we've got our three pigs. I got one taking a nap, who will probably be out here in a minute. I got a couple other ones out here, but they're getting big. So these pigs are probably a good 200, 250 pounds at this point, and they are eating a lot, including my leg from time to time. But they eat a lot. We've got an organic feed that we're going with on this round. Got a great deal on some organic feed, but it's very expensive. So that's obviously the biggest cost when you're raising pigs. So we're obviously always looking for ways that we can reduce those costs. So feeding them different things here on the farm. So one of the things we came across, stumbled across last week was something a little different. So we want to share that with you today. But the reason why. So here on this farm, we're limited on space. So we got about 700 square feet or so that these three pigs are on, which is fine, but we are going to give them more space. Really, our goal is to do pastured pigs, as pastured as it gets here in the desert. And on our new property, we're going to be able to do that. I'll link our video series here on our new property, but we'll be able to do that there. But what we want to do with these pigs as we get closer and closer to that last day here on the farm is we want to make sure that they're eating something similar to a pasture-based diet for a pig, something more what they would eat in the wild. So where we're challenged with here is we don't have a lot of that here. There's nothing like that here in their pig pen, but we are surrounded by a few things here in the middle of winter in Arizona that we just so happen to figure out they love. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut real quick, show you what we're talking about. Okay, so here's the pasture. So what we did is we're just, maybe about a mile or so from the farm, and we're out here in what would typically be a pasture if pigs were running around out here wild. So what we have behind us here is just a nice big stand of mallow. And what we wanna do is we wanna see if we can go ahead and get some free pig feed and actually treat those pigs like a pastured pig should be treated. So Lori and I are gonna spend a few minutes, take some of this stand down or out, bring it back to the farm with us, and let's see how they like it. All right, so now you get an idea of what we're talking about. So one of the things that's great about getting rain here in the middle of winter here in the desert is we get mallow. This stuff grows like weeds, because it is a weed, all over the place out here. So what we look for is not private land, but we look for public land, public right-of-ways, and this stuff kind of grows on the side of the road. Usually what happens is the county will come out and they'll actually trim it down, so they'll actually just bushwhack it down to try to get rid of it. So what you saw there was us kind of helping them out a little bit. So we actually pulled these. So these are mallow. We've got the mallow root, the stems, the leaves, all good stuff for these guys. So what I want to do is I want to show you just how much they like mallow. And also the amount. So we filled this thing up. I'm guessing this is at least 30 to 40 pounds of mallow. It's a lot of mallow. So for these three pigs, this is going to last them a couple days. So we'll feed them this for the next couple of days, mixed in with the feed that they have, free choice. So let's see how they like the mallow. Pig. If we can get Bacon, our lazy one, who's taking a nap. So if Lori wants to get a close-up on this, you'll see they really do like mallow. So they'll come through and they will literally eat all of this. But you can see they'll chew on the leaves, chew on the stems, and they'll chew on those roots. A lot of benefits to mallow. Won't get into those here. You guys can Google that. So there's health benefits to it. I'm not a vet. I don't know if there's health benefits for pigs. But we know he hurt his leg about a week or so ago, was kind of hobbling on it. He's doing much, much better on that. don't think it's the mallow, but they've been eating mallow now for about a week or so. But they'll go through this now and just tear it to shreds. What we love is we get a reduced feed bill and they get greens. So they get something that if they were on pasture, especially here in Arizona, in fact, we checked our property, it has mallow growing on it where they'll be already. So it's already there and established. So they're gonna have access to mallow. Our pigs will have access to mallow in our desert pasture here in the middle of winter, and a great alternate feed source for them. All right, so I just want to thank you guys for joining us today. You know what, if you haven't done so already, hey, subscribe to the channel. You know, we cover a lot of different things here on the farm, fruit trees, chickens, pigs, lots of different things we cover here on the farm. You know, we got a 6-acre property we're going to be moving on to, turning it into, taking it from desert to a permaculture type farm where we do a lot of this sustainable, regenerative agriculture. We'd love it if you would join us. You know, if you haven't checked us out on Instagram and Facebook, hey, do so. There's things that we post up there that you won't find here on YouTube. And if you have any questions or comments, hey, leave them in the comment section down below. You know, Lori and I are still learning this farming game. So if you guys have great tips and ideas, we'd love to see those from you as well. So just want to thank you for joining us today and remind you, if we can farm on the edge of nowhere, so can you. Got an organic feed that we went with. That's my boot. Stop eating my boot. Stop eating my boot. So that's my boot. So what I have in front of me here is a trash, I was gonna say trash tank. It's not a trash tank. It's a trash barrel. Try again. But we talk a lot about different things. So I'm gonna start over. Got pigs eating weeds. Threw me off. Threw me for a loop.